Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Late Night Tavern with your host, me and Henry. And on today's episode, we have two guests, Leslie and MJ.
Hello.
Hey.
We have two guests.
MJ is a YouTuber, but you... Leslie is a YouTuber, and we made a video with her. I don't know if that's going to come up before this one. Probably not, because this one has to go up on Saturday. So, you'll see a video with me
eventually
and Marco with her and MJ, and then you'll also see one on her channel.
That's all right, correct. Way to ruin the video. Way to spoil it.
What?
Oh, that's a wham right there.
That's a wham right there.
That's a wham.
Hey, but they don't know how the struggles that I went through.
Doesn't
that
matter.
They don't know the struggles.
It's still
what happened.
Spoiled.
Man, whatever.
Like rotten milk.
That's all right. We'll edit that part out.
So, you know, if you want to see those videos, keep an eye out for our video, and then we'll put her channel in the description so you can go watch those videos.
Exactly.
So
that's a WAP.
That is a WAP.
That's a WAP.
So I got some questions to ask you about vlogging.
Go right ahead.
Do you feel that people were annoyed if you did it in class?
Honestly, everybody that pretended to be annoyed was just mad because they wanted to be in it but not asked to be in it.
Ooh.
And I mean that in like the most humble way possible.
Facts.
I get you.
Like, cause there's people that will literally only talk to me when I'm vlogging, and facts. they're like come up to me and they're like pose behind me. They're like, I'm throwing up a peace sign, by the way, and they're like just posing there, and it's like, okay, but like you've never spoken to me ever.
Facts.
You know.
And
so that's.
I have a question.
Go right ahead.
How do you feel about people making TikToks in public?
I love it. I think it's so funny. It makes it that much funnier.
Do you ever feel
so
cringe
ballsy
from it?
Of course, but like the good kind of cringe,
you know?
Remember,
like the beginning of the year, I was in the library, and I saw Leslie behind me, her in front of me, just making a
yeah,
TikTok.
I remember.
And I walked up to her, and I was like, what are you doing? And she's like, watch TikTok.
Renegade.
That might have been what she was doing at the time.
I don't think so. I don't even think Renegade was a thing yet.
It was probably about Fast and Furious.
No. Oh, it was. Was it with Julie?
No, it was just you.
It was just me? Oh. Then it was the one where...
And then you're like, here, watch. Come here real quick. And you put it on the chair, and you're like, watch this.
I don't even think I have those straps anymore. That is so sad. But hold on, wait. I was wearing like a gray shirt, right?
I think so.
Do you remember?
I think it was August.
I'm talking about August of last year.
I remember that day specifically.
Because we were in the library before we were allowed to get our free period passes to leave. She was just chilling there, just like...
Dancing, yeah.
And I was like, what the fuck?
I think it's really ballsy when people do.
And I was like, it's popping.
Yeah.
I gave him credit.
It was the same thing. Right?
Yeah, well, yeah, that's probably what you were doing.
This is exactly what I was doing. I was doing this in the library.
Yeah, it was. That's what it was. Stop before you get covered.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, guys. But, yeah. Oh, you can. I can tell you later because I don't want to repeat it. I'm sorry. But, yeah. I love making TikToks in public when I have the balls.
Yeah, I kind of feel like if I was in that situation, I wouldn't. Like, I mean, like, if I was really into making them, I feel like I would do it. But at the same time, I'm not. I don't know what the fuck I would do.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't know.
Our TikToks have just been our Snapchat memories.
Oh, that's, I like those TikToks too because they feel nostalgic even if it's not your memories.
I jumped off a roof.
Yeah,
Jesus.
I jumped off.
That was one of them.
That roof right there.
There's one.
You
of
can't see it.
The apple
but,
right here.
Mm-hmm.
But you can see it if you go look at it.
Yeah, I punched the apple right here on this table.
Like when it's a collab of like funny memories.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, they're not. It's just the one.
Oh.
It'll,
okay,
then
okay.
It'll be like next video.
Mm-hmm.
And I was going through a bunch of them and I was like, man, I can't post these. I was like, I can't post a lot of these ones, but I probably can. I just have to look harder. Maybe if I could censor them or something.
I have to burp.
What about? The New York vlog.
What about it?
How was that? Doing that one on public.
Because
you were, you know, you were being filmed. You weren't really holding it.
Mm-hmm. So honestly, it was really frustrating because my mom doesn't know how to work my phone. Because that's what I record with. A lot of people ask me that sometimes. What do I record with? Because everybody thinks that I record with like a...
sorry, we're not laughing at you. We're not laughing at you. Keep on going.
I feel disrespected.
With the Sony one right there?
Yeah, everybody thinks I record with this one, but I don't even like recording this because it doesn't look right. So I've always recorded with my phone. And she doesn't know how to hold it. Like, she just, she shakes it and stuff. So editing that video was a nightmare. But being in public, I don't think, I didn't feel awkward at all, which is weird.
I really liked that video, though. When you posted it, I was watching it like this. It like nice. That seal.
Aww. Oh, dude.
The one that smiles.
Yeah. Because I was like, oh, man. I was like, this is good.
Thanks.
And I can see it took time. I did like the little coronavirus bit.
Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you.
Because I was thinking, relatable. I was like, why was she in New York?
Yeah,
I know.
But then she's like, we just found out. I was like, all right, you get a pass.
Yeah.
You just slide on that. How was working during this whole pandemic?
How was working?
Still, so.
I still am. I work at McDonald's, if any of you guys are wondering. But honestly, at first, I was a little bit iffy about it. But then I was like, money. So, and honestly, the pandemic hasn't really changed it other than you guys can't eat in there, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's just drive-thru. But even then, it's still, like, super stressful. Like,
is it more, like, heated in there because you have to wear a mask around, like, all the grills and shit?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I don't really know what it was like before, like, not wearing masks in there, but I know it does get really hot. So, yeah.
I know I asked you this before, but that fucking ice cream machine.
I know, it really does break down, you guys, but I have a confession to make. I actually have told people that the ice cream isn't working because I don't want to make cones or something.
Okay, that's exactly what I asked her. I was like, so is it really broken or are people too lazy? And then she's like,
what about the coffee when they're like, we just cleaned it?
Oh, yeah, that's completely true because it's super easy to make the coffee and stuff. Mm-hmm. So if somebody tells you that it's being cleaned, it usually is.
Oh, okay. I don't order coffee from there, so I wouldn't.
Once the lady was, she didn't say we're cleaning it. She said we just cleaned it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
So wow, I was like, so you can't make
so
a
was
cup
like,
of coffee?
Yeah, and?
So you don't smell
I want my
bitch
fucking coffee.
No, yeah.
You can't just.
I'm like a coffee fiend. I don't know how upset I was.
So you've been working there ever since it started, right?
I've been working there since May, so.
So you
basically.
Haven't had like the restaurant open?
Mm-hmm.
Have you had any heated situations there?
Yeah, like that chick that would like beat your ass if you didn't give her nuggets.
She's like, you give me my nuggets. I thought he was
like,
where's my 10 piece at?
And she started
beating your ass.
No, but
Karen.
Yes, I was about to say it, but I've had a lot of Karens because I'm usually at the first drive thru. And that's the first drive thru is where you take orders and you pay and stuff. So one time I had this lady and she literally got heated.
What's her name and address?
Fuck, I don't know. I'm sorry, am I allowed to curse?
Yeah, what? Are you allowed to curse? You're just
how
not
many
allowed
times
to...
have I fucking cussed on
I know,
here?
I know.
You're just not allowed to say the bad
You can't
thing.
Say
bad
shit.
Slurs.
You can't say shit.
Yeah.
Slut?
You can,
no,
say, slut?
You can say that. You can't say the
Why would you say that?
Oh, sorry. Well, we'll edit it out.
I'm just kidding. Oh my gosh, Henry.
Oh, fuck. Oh my god. Where? Where?
Karen's. Yeah, so basically, she ordered, like, I don't even know what she ordered, but it was, like, two cheeseburgers or something.
That's the first burger. What the fuck?
It was, like, two cheeseburgers, and then she comes back. Dude,
that's
true.
Fucked.
She comes back, and she's like, yeah, I'm really upset because you guys gave me the wrong order. And so I was like, okay, so what was the order? And she was like, two milkshakes.
What a
and
dumb
I was like,
bitch.
Huh. I was like, huh.
Dumb bitch.
I was like, I was like, so... I really wanted to tell her, I was like, so why'd you take the two milkshakes if it was two cheeseburgers? And she didn't give a fuck, so we had to give her a refund and crap.
Oh, is that one snap?
And then MJ over here.
Oh my god!
She
almost,
okay, go right ahead. I almost lost my job because of you.
What?
I'm just kidding.
I didn't call in because I didn't want you to lose your job.
Okay, whatever.
Okay, so I like love McDonald's. I'm sick like that, sick in the head.
Sick in the head.
And I went to get breakfast, and I was splurging on this breakfast. I got like, I don't even know what I got, like a biscuit sandwich, and
sandwich. I like that shit.
Sandwich.
That's on my
like,
fucking.
I like,
God,
no,
that's
I like
sandwich.
That. I like that
she says sandwich.
And the McGriddle sandwich, and a coffee, right? Okay, so Leslie this time wasn't in the first window where I pay. She was in the second window, and her manager was there. And I was like, hey, Lizzie. And she was like, shh, my manager. She was like pointing at him. And I was like, oh, I was just saying hi. And she like hands me this and she reads the order back to me. She's like, a McGriddle sandwich and blah, 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 right? And I was like, yeah. And I take it. Really, like, I usually check it, like, before I drive off. But considering Leslie, like, even read it back to me, I was like, shit, okay. And I drove home. And I opened the bag, and it's like...
It's like a completely different order.
It's like a like four cheap sausage patties.
Burritos or something. Wait, what?
The wraps? The McMuffins.
Oh.
Bro, I'd be heated as fuck if I didn't get a McGriddle. It was a McMuffin.
I was heated.
Bro, I would.
It was like it was just the bread, the ham, and the bread. What are those?
Oh my god,
yeah, biscuits. That sounds whack as fuck.
It was like three of
McMuffin
those.
McMuffin or some shit.
Sandwich.
And not what I wanted. I was heated, and I didn't call back because I was like, no, because Leslie was working.
Exactly.
My brain was about to explode.
Yeah, I thought it was funny you posted on Snapchat. I was like, ah. I was going to text you about it and be like, you fucked up that bad.
It was like a completely different order. I was so mad. Like
that. I think I cried.
For real. I would have cried too. I remember one time I was a kid. My dad and I were coming back from McDonald's. Mm-hmm. And we lived upstairs. And I was walking and I dropped my soda, bro, and I was sad as fuck. It like splashed. I was
sad.
Like,
so sad.
Fuck. Someone else had to give me the soda.
Wait, you were a little kid and you said
yeah.
Fuck?
Well, probably. In my head. In my head, I would have been like, fuck.
I remember, what was it? A couple.
I think I might have cried.
Like, I think 2 months ago, I went to Sup Cricket.
Hey.
Damn.
So, hi. Don't fucking matter. What's that dude?
Yeah, it's okay.
Anyway, so I went to pizza, and when I went over there, my grandma ordered this pizza already at that, and I decided to go pick it up. So I went over there, I picked it up, and then I got wings too. Like, then I was like, oh, fuck yeah, we got wings too. I came back over here, and then I brought them right there. She's like, so I didn't order wings like that. I'm like, and I looked at it, it was from the wrong person. They gave me the wrong order. Goodness. I thought I was like, shit.
Did you take it back?
Yeah, I took it back.
As you should.
I took it back. Should. And then they gave me my pizza or whatever. No, I paid, but the fucked up thing about it is I paid for it.
Oh.
I got the card because like usually when you have to pick it up, you don't have to pay for it.
Uh-huh.
But she just told me, like, here, take the card just in case. And I paid for the other guy's thing. And dude. I was like, fuck. Like that. And so I went over there and I told him, I was like, oh, that was, oh, sorry about that. And then so I didn't realize that. And then I had to go back a third time. Mm-hmm. And I said, like, well, like, can I get the money back? Uh-huh. That because that's not my order. And then they're like, oh, here you go, like that. And I got my pizza at the end, but like I paid for the other person. It was like $40.
But did you get your money back?
Yeah, I got it back. Oh, but okay. I was like I paid for that. She's like, you paid for it. I was like, yeah. I was like, sorry,
it should hurt. So he got a free meal anyway.
No, I think he still had to pay for it in the end, or I don't know. I don't know.
You got your money back, but it was still paid.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, right.
He went to go pick up his stuff like that. He's like, oh, it's 44 something like that. He's like, it's free at that. He's like, who paid for it? That's whack.
Damn. That is whack.
Major fuck up.
Someone fucked up our Pizza Hut order the other day.
Really?
Yeah, like someone was like, hey, you want a pizza for your birthday? I was like, sure. They're like, you want wings? And I was like, I can't eat wings. So I said no, but then my mom was like, should've got
wait,
some
wait,
for your
wait,
brother.
Pause. Why can't you eat wings?
If it'll burn my stomach like no one's business.
Diarrhea.
No, just the inner walls of my stomach, it'll just...
Oh, they'll just burn.
Yeah.
Oh. Yikes.
I might get diarrhea also as like a complimentary prize, but...
Hey, man, so, but if you take a bite out of it, you're going to enjoy it for the first, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
After
well, so here's what happened. I called her back, and I said, hey, can you get the buffalo wings for my brother? And she's like, sure. And then I didn't know which one he wanted, so he got buffalo boneless wings. I was like, so, yeah, you can get him chicken nuggets with boneless wing sauce on it, buffalo sauce on
it.
Oh,
well, that's all a boneless wing is,
a chicken nugget. And so then they came, and then it was honey barbecue, and I was like, I'm mad for him. But then I took a bite out of it. I was like, holy shit, this is pretty good.
I'm just going to say this real quick.
What?
I don't like barbecue wings.
Me either.
Yeah, me either.
Well, it's just like dipping chicken nuggets in barbecue
sauce.
Like,
I like wings that have sauce, like hot sauce
hot
on them.
Sauce.
I don't like them with barbecues. It kind of just feels like they get cold fast as fuck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I ate them in like 3 seconds, so that's why.
I mean, that's I'm just saying, like, I fucking
don't
like.
But we tried calling back, and they didn't want to do it. Well, they said they were going to do it, and then they called person who ordered it and told them that they couldn't do it, but they didn't tell us that.
Oh.
So we're the people that got the things, and I was like, man, I'm sorry. I even called her back to get you more fucking buffalo wings because I felt bad.
All right,
bone
so,
in? Oh.
So I got a question for everybody right here.
Wow.
We were talking about it right now before we started. Mm-hmm. How do you guys feel about fake, like, you know, prosthetics to a person?
Or like yeah.
You
oh,
pay,
like surgery.
Fake like, ass. Surgeries, like that fake ass, tits, whatever.
What's it called?
Honestly,
plastic surgery.
Yeah. If I had the money, I would do it. But I just hate on all people that do it because I can't.
Oh, okay.
So I'm a hypocrite, basically.
Yeah. She's a hypocrite.
You think when okay, say imagine like okay, so like someone right there, a girl like that. You think if once they have it, they hit different.
They hit different.
Honestly, yeah.
Depends if I'm attracted to this person specifically.
Honestly, I do think so. They do hit different. Because obviously.
I'm right there for it. Like I think if it looks good.
It's a hypocrite.
That is a hypocrite.
If it looks good, then yeah.
It's a hypocrite right there.
Mm. It's worth it. But like if it doesn't look that good, like where you could tell like, oh, like you see a girl with her ass popping out more and her legs are skinnier than anything. That's not.
Yeah.
That's too much.
Wait, I have a question.
All right.
If you guys could get plastic surgery, what would you get?
Oh my gosh, I got a list.
Well.
Okay, so I'd get a BBL.
The fuck is that?
It's Brazilian butt lift.
But not for like my butt, because I like my butt. It's more for like my
hip dips,
because they're really bad. And of course, like to perk up my butt. And then I'd get some Botox on my double chin to make it slimmer, because it ruins so many pictures. And probably my boobs done. I don't know, bigger or smaller. It depends, because they're like wonky.
Wonky.
They're wonky.
Well, I'm pretty sure making them bigger or smaller, they'd probably adjust.
That's why.
Wonky or whatever the fuck you said.
So they're not wonky, so they're...
A wonky. Perky.
What about you guys?
I don't.
The head, the forehead reduction.
Forehead reduction?
Yeah.
They scalp you and just trim it.
Yeah, they skim. They give me like hair. Four, like,
hair.
Like they put
hair
right here.
Starts right here, Margo.
You look like a fucking caveman.
And dental work. Dental work.
Dental work.
Is like a gap.
I think my only thing would probably be the chin thing.
Yeah.
The chin thing.
Botox.
Other than that, I'm fucking chilling.
Wow.
They can
push.
I have no idea.
Oh, have you seen Zane Kajazi?
Is that a thing?
Yeah, they can do that.
They can extend. They could extend your dong.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah,
they actually can.
They can.
Yeah.
So they put more skin.
No, the rest of it that's in you.
Oh,
they gotta pull it out.
Yeah.
Because there's like an extra like 2-3 inches in.
It's like a Chinese
finger trap.
Yeah, but like you just.
Ouch. Zane Kajazi, he got his hairline done, and it like looks better. It looks really good.
Imagine, how do they do that?
They put
hair implants.
They put like follicle
like Elon Musk.
Stuff.
Yeah.
So like forehead reduction thingy is that a surgery?
I don't know. They might just put more hair right there.
I think it's shots.
Yeah, I think it's shots of like your plasma, I think. And they put it here.
It's gonna look all fucking wrinkly.
It's gonna be a wrinkle. I wish I just had my big fucking forehead back again.
I don't know. I don't think it's really that big of a deal when you have all your hair.
You go to the barbers and they line you up and you're ready to go.
Like,
come on, get out of your boy.
Yeah. What'd you get done?
Oh, would I get done?
Yeah.
Oh, she talked about it the other day.
Wait, what did I say?
On your live.
Oh, I wasn't there.
What did I say?
You're like...
Oh, yeah. So basically, let me tell you guys a story. I saw this one girl on TikTok and she had a completely different nose than what she used to have.
Charlie D'Amelio?
No, but she did. She did get a.
Yeah, she fixed her nose or something.
Oh, it is really cute. She has the cutest nose. But this girl, she has like a completely different nose now, and she claims she manifested it. So I was like, I was like, bet. I was like, let me try this out. So I'm doing nose workouts right now. That's what I'm doing. So obviously, I would get my nose done. I would get my butt done. I don't think I would get my boobs done because I'm pretty okay with my boobs.
I think you're nice.
Thank you. And that's it. That's all I would get done.
Then when I was watching that live and you were like, I do nose workouts, and I was like, the fuck?
How do you know that?
What I first did? I was like flexing my nose like that, and then she started doing it and I was like, this is the most bullshit I've ever heard in my life.
Does it like give you like muscles on your nose right here, make them like
probably on your like nostrils?
I think it's
like
supposed to like tighten
nose.
It.
So basically like the cartilage, she claims it's moldable. So so I like squeeze my nose, like if I'm popping a pimple or something, I do that and I press it upward and I flex downward like that.
Uh-huh. I think Leslie has the cutest nose. I really like it.
The
like,
what the fuck?
For real, on my life, I will die saying that. And I think I don't care if she gets anything done.
They're both looking at her like she's a fucking.
No, I'm not.
You guys,
I don't care.
I think it's dumb how much you hate your nose.
I don't care if she gets anything done. Like, I'm all for supporting her, but I really think her nose is so cute, and I just.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Speaking about the life.
Hold on, she drew a dog. She drew my dog, and look at how it came up.
Are you screenshotting?
Yeah.
That shit looks.
I'm sorry.
Wait, that's actually kind of sick.
Because she started drawing, she's like, I fucked it up.
I fucked it up.
And then she came out with two legs and a box body, but then I asked her to draw Garfield.
Kind of sick.
Hey, John.
The dog's kind of sick.
She forgot how to draw Garfield. She's like, what the fuck does Garfield look like? It was like an orange cat.
Well, speaking of your life.
Yeah.
Well, how do you want to talk about this? Because I don't know how to word it right about the whole editing thing.
Oh, yeah. How's your editing going?
How's my editing going?
No, because I know you. Because I know.
Not for her video.
I know you do editing for other people.
Oh, yeah. So, there's these boys, right? I'm pretty sure.
Boy.
Yeah.
Hey,
John. Okay, it's fine. Their name is SPMG. I edited a couple videos for them. It consists of. Well, we can shout them out, right? That's fine.
Well, if you're dissing them, then probably not.
I'm not going to diss on them.
And that.
It's good. Okay, so I used to edit for these boys, correction. And according to them, like, we had this agreement that they were only going to pay me $20 per video.
That's fucking whack.
Exactly. I think it's like, that's like nothing. And it's a bunch of them. They were all playing $5.
Right. It's not
$5?
It's not that bad.
Exactly. And so I was like, hey, I was like, is it okay? I literally asked him, I was like, is this okay if I raise the price a little bit?
It should be like $10 each.
Yeah. So that's what I told him. I was like, is it okay?
That's an expensive ass video.
Fuck
for
it.
$10 from each one of them?
Fuck, that's $50.
Like, I'm not agreeing with them, but like, holy shit.
Five people?
It's six of them, actually.
Like, that, you'd
60
be making,
bucks right
you'd
there.
Be making bread as fuck.
Exactly. And they were like, oh, yeah, for sure. And so then after
they
I finished.
Agreed.
Just yes,
saying.
They agreed. And
so I'm not going to put them in the description if they're against you.
And to this day, they still think that I agreed to them paying me $20. Like, why would I agree to a lower price, you know? And so they pull up to my work through the drive-thru, and they're like, hey, we're not going to pay you the amount that you said. And I was like...
They pulled up to your work?
They
told
up to
you
my
that?
Work.
Did they even buy anything from there?
Yeah, they did.
Okay.
Wow,
well, I mean, that's still bullshit. That's
exactly.
still,
like, breaking
Mad
up with you.
Bullshit.
Imagine if someone
exactly.
broke up with you like that. Hey, we're done.
Give me my fucking McDonald's.
So my boyfriend,
bitch.
Please don't break up with me.
Oh my god, break up with her.
No, please don't.
Don't do it in the drive for
her.
don't
break up with me.
Okay, but don't break up with her mean. Oh, he's a dick anyways. I don't know.
No, he's not. He's the sweetest. But, okay.
Okay, I don't know how much you want me to edit here, bro.
You don't have to edit
wham,
that.
Wham, wham.
Oh, yeah. So they came through the they came through the drive-thru, and they were like, we're not going to pay you the amount that we said. And I was like, we can talk about this later. You guys gotta go, or else I'm gonna get fired. Cause if I keep a car there for too long, like it messes up with the times and stuff. So I texted them, and they were like, "Dude, they were like, you agreed that we were gonna pay you this, and this was all like after I had posted their video, so it's not like I could be like,
she had already posted it.
Yeah.
I have a question.
Yeah,
so I watched the video.
Mm-hmm. And it's ass.
Okay, so all.
Why
the
do you want us to shout him out?
all the editing for you. Was you, right?
Mm-hmm. All of it.
Why did they ask you to put that much into it, or is that what your part?
Honestly, that was me.
Did you feel like that was going to make it better?
Mm-hmm, I felt like that was going to make it better because they had a lot of parts where they didn't really plan out their videos. So there was.
That's whack as fuck.
Yeah, so there's a bunch of spots where they, like, they aren't. Where they're just, like, silent and they're just, like, waiting for something to happen. And it's like, well.
Yeah, they
no.
have almost
something
like that.
Exactly. Like, they're all looking, like, super. Like, they don't know what they're doing. So.
Simps.
Mm hmm.
Okay.
Sure.
Nah.
And so
there's no evidence of that one.
I take that back.
It was really hard to edit their videos.
I think it's really hard for us to do videos because we have to be like, if one of us stops talking, it's noticeable.
Yeah.
And it happened in one video, and I felt bad for it, but we the first two or three, four episodes maybe, mm-hmm. we like planned it, and I even brought in his laptop to like have discussions.
Mm-hmm. Episode A was dog shit. Don't watch.
But
it.
Then, but then after a while, we stopped. Planning,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes it works, and sometimes we're like, right before we're about to start, we're like, oh fuck,
Yeah, like, what do we talk about?
Yeah.
It happened kind of here. Mm-hmm. We were like that. That's why I asked you to kind of bring some stuff. But yeah, it's fine because it's all good.
Yeah.
It always happens whenever just me and him are doing it. We're like, what the fuck do we talk about?
Yeah.
It's like, we just come up with one thing and then we're like,
and now what?
We have to, like, really improvise the shit out of the rest of it. Mm-hmm. We get, like, a good 10 minutes of a discussion we want. And like, 50.
50, the other half of it's like,
So,
how do you feel about Tuesdays?
How do you feel about the weather this morning?
Shit's cold.
You guys want to hear my drinks?
Clink. Clink, clink, bitch.
So, your whole thing with them is done?
Yeah, it's all done. And I even thought about, like, not... Because I thought it was my fault, you know? They really made it seem like it was my fault. And I'm not going to try and, like, bash on them, but, like, they made me feel really shitty, and it was, like, super degrading. So it was, like, not good. Like, the whole situation with them was just, like, toxic for me.
You hear that? You're garbage.
No.
Well, I said you're garbage.
Okay. Well, everyone's entitled to their own opinion, but you can go ahead and elaborate.
I said it. Garbage.
Yeah. To each their own. And so, yeah.
Pray for me.
Pray for you? Nah. What the fuck?
Yeah, and some of them still have to pay me, so... Like, and it wasn't even, like, they came to me to pay me. Like, no, like, I had to go look for them. I had to text them. I had to be like, hey, you're gonna pay me. Hey, can I pick it up now? It was like that. And I was actually doing that today.
Immature.
Mm-hmm.
It's immature. I fucking hate that. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of an impatient person.
Irresponsible. There we go.
Of them.
I thought you were going to say he was
irresponsible.
Was, no, of them. A little bit.
But, I mean, you're not wrong.
You're not wrong, but I mean, like, I wouldn't say that much. Because
you didn't have to say it.
I'm very, you know, impatient when it comes to things. And when people have to pay me or, like, they have to do something that, like, you know, that's for me, I get really impatient or, like, I kind of, like, wanted them, like, you know.
Yeah. So, like, us coming, getting here late, that made you, like,
No, you weren't even late.
Well, you guys came on time. Well, what I mean by, like, when it's, like if I'm waiting for someone, like, not,
what time did you guys show up?
Like, an hour later.
Well, yeah. If you would have showed up at, like, 9, I would have been pretty pissed.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But, like, I'm saying for, like, someone has to pay me money, and they haven't paid me, like, in more than, like, a week.
Yeah.
That pisses me off. Or, like, here's another example. Like, if I take someone to the store or something, or, like, when someone says, like, only be, like, 5 minutes, like, an hour later, you know, they come back at them. It's like, sorry, fuck, you said, like, 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I'm kind of that way more so now, because ever since we started doing YouTube, I was like, okay, we can't, the only person I have to rely on is him, that I'm trying to make it so that I only have to rely on him. You know, Sergio does our art or whatever, so I have to rely on him, too, but I'm trying to limit the reliability of anybody so that... I can get what I need done instead of being like, hey, did you get that done? They're like, no. And I'd be like, well, great. Well, I have a video due this day. Mm-hmm. And if you don't have it done, then I'm fucked.
Yeah.
So now I'm like that. Maybe with other things, I might not be. But I might be like with money or something. But not many situations like that come. I'm usually kind of just doing shit my own or asking him.
Yeah.
How'd you become a good dancer?
Oh, you think I'm a good dancer?
Was that a segue?
Wait, you guys actually...
How do you become... What?
Well,
what
I mean,
brought you to dancing, I guess?
Holy shit, that's crazy.
I could have sworn I remember you did something like the professional... But
yeah, she used to dance.
Yeah, so I've been to a couple competitions. And I've never... Actually, I've won first place, but that was like in... When I was like 11.
Swag sauce?
So I started dancing when I was like 3 years old. It started off with like ballet and stuff, you know, like the regular... And then when I moved, no. I think I, like in elementary, I did a little experimenting and I got into hip hop and I feel like that's what I'm best at right now. And so that's when I moved here and then I got into jazz and contemporary. So that was pretty cool. But yeah, I've been dancing like since I was little.
So you think like if someone had like a competition like right now, you think you could beat them?
I think she
could. Like with you guys?
Well, no, like
no shit, you'd win, but
I could like do some shit, but I'm not good as fuck.
I don't know. There's a lot of good dancers here. I don't think I could compete with
them.
When
did you learn how to do the splits?
When I was like,
because when you posted that thing you did on Snapchat the other day, I was like, I was like, you can do that. This shit's cool as fuck.
I don't know. I think I've always just been flexible.
Because I kind of thought you were just gonna do like. Kind of like a backflip almost, like handstand backwards, but then you split it and it was like, whoa!
Yeah.
That blew my fucking mind.
Thanks.
Shwelcome.
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 What about soccer? How do you feel about soccer?
Soccer? I think soccer's super fun, but I do suck at it. I actually have a Tori. I have a Tori. Senior year soccer was shit. Like, it was so bad. I don't know if you guys even went
that
to,
that weather,
like,
sucked when you guys would play.
Yeah, the weather sucks.
I know.
Days.
It was cold as fuck.
And so
I was colder than shit.
When you had games after my track practices?
Yeah. But the thing was that it was super cold, right? And I didn't even get to play. So, like, I had to be sitting on the bench in my shorts, like, basically naked. And just because the coaches didn't want to play me, I get it, I suck, but, like, let me warm up a little, you know? It's fucking cold. Exactly.
I was fucking cold. I was like,
I know, you were holding the sign, and
dude,
I was like,
my fingers were redder than shit.
I'm sorry.
I was like this. I was like,
oh. I'd be outside for 3 seconds, dude, in her games, and I'd be ashy in 2 seconds.
Darren was there, like a G. Oh, my God. If I was there by myself, because he had to hold it sometimes, and then my fingers were just, like, dead. And I was like,
oh.
And he's like, get your hot coffee. And I was like,
oh.
Nice.
Aw. That's nice, Darren.
I almost did at one point, but then I was like, "That's gonna hurt like a bitch."
Yeah. All right. I just dropped the tooth. Okay, so if you won $1 million, would you save it or would you spend it immediately?
I don't think
for everybody.
I don't think I would spend it immediately, but I would start spending.
Yeah.
What about you?
I feel like I'd buy things.
Essentials.
Like, probably a house for my parents.
Mm-hmm.
And
another nice
car, and I'd pay for whatever bills I need that need to be paid or something essential in
you
my life.
You pay for bills for like months.
Well, not months. I wouldn't pay for all of them. Just like probably for the rest of the year from now, and then put the rest of it in a savings account so it can like accumulate
interest.
Right.
Free cash.
What about you, Henry? Oh, sorry. Were you gonna answer?
I'd stock it up. Not right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right now it's pretty bad to put it in the stocks or whatever, but I would probably try to invest it as much as possible.
Like in Netflix?
Not right now.
Wait, why not?
Because it's getting a lot of shit right now, so stocks might go down.
Wait, really?
You ever heard about the whole thing about why it's
being
bad?
The cuties thing?
Oh, because of the pedophile.
Yeah.
The cuties thing, you could say it. The cuties thing?
The pedophile.
The pedals.
You know that movie, Cuties?
No.
It's about like these 11-year-old girls that are like wanting to become professional, like,
workers
or some shit. And like the trailer's like real creepy because you're like looking at it and you're like, man, those little girls went to filming every day looking like that. And they had to do shit for like older people, which are most likely men. And I was like, that shit's creepy as fuck.
And like
shocked you haven't seen that. They've been getting a lot of shit.
It got deleted, but like, you know how Netflix has descriptions? It was like some like little kids dancing or something was like one of the tags. That like was targeted. Oh, little kids twerking.
Little girl, 11-year-old girls twerking or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Was in one of the tags in the description, and then that's like targeted towards like pedophiles.
And honestly,
but they deleted that.
It's real creepy too, because like the picture is just like the girls in like their dance wear and whatever. It's like short shorts and like crop top kind of deal, and they're all like dancing. And I'm like, ugh. It's like this is really weird.
I didn't watch it.
I haven't even seen it.
I don't think the movie.
I don't even know what it looks like.
I'm shocked that the movie's still gonna come out. I don't think it's going to... I would hope that it wouldn't be coming out.
I hope it doesn't.
But they're like, you know, they're like, oh, we changed the description so that it wouldn't affect the French award-winning movie. And I was like...
It is French.
Yeah, it's not like a Netflix-exclusive movie, but it is still weird that they're putting it on there.
Creme de la crème.
And they're saying that they changed it because they were like, oh, we're sorry, we changed it. But I feel like they more so changed it so that no one would, like, see it anymore.
Well, okay, so anyways, it's about $1 million.
Yeah, but
right?
No, I would invest it, not Netflix or Tesla, because anything that dude says immediately drops that thing. After he smoked weed on the Joe Rogan podcast, it plummeted like crazy.
Whoa.
All right, so mine, I'm like the complete polar opposite.
All your money would be gone in a day.
It wouldn't be gone in a day. It'd be gone within like maybe like a couple months. I think the only reason is I'd probably spend $100,000 in an hour.
On a car.
If someone was telling me that I was getting $1 million on like a date, I could plan all of that $1 million out so that when I get it, it's all gone.
It'll be a car and a house for sure.
The car
first though.
I'd buy a bear.
A bear?
A grizzly bear. Security.
I went to Sierra Vista yesterday.
Yeah.
I never seen a raccoon ever in my life.
A trash panda.
I never seen a trash panda ever in my life, and when we were right there, I saw a dead one in the middle of the road. I was like, I was so excited to see it though. I was like, it's dead, but it's a raccoon.
But if I had a bear and someone like tried to break into my house and they're like, bam, got a bear now.
That's freaking crazy. Like a bear, that's so random.
Would that be funny though?
I want a duck.
I feel like that's illegal.
I had a duck.
No, you can have a bear and
I actually did have a duck.
I want like a
You guys can keep talking. I'm just
What? I don't know.
Well anyways, but other than that, I wanted a fucking a duck, a raccoon, and a fucking a duck, raccoon, and the fuck? I forgot what the fuck I said it yesterday. Like my fucking
grandparents also. I made this whole list of like what he would spend.
A duck, a raccoon, and a fucking
chimpanzee,
elephant, Black tiger.
I get a monkey.
Honestly, yeah,
a monkey.
My mom would love a monkey.
I remember, like, on the first, what was the second or third episode, there was a little Mikey in here.
Oh, there's a little mouse in here.
Oh, a little. I know, I thought monkey.
I know.
Yeah, you threw up dead. I thought there was like, no, but we
Mikey's
just.
Mikey the horse?
No, it's. Yeah, Mikey the horse and Chad the spider.
Yeah, Chad
Mikey
the spider.
Mikey is a horse that eats Big Macs.
Big Macs.
Mikey.
And Chad the spider is a...
He likes it, though.
It's like a spider
you give
with
it
like,
to him
super...
Oh, you guys named them. I thought you guys were talking about, like, cartoons, and I was
well,
like...
Well, they're not real.
Oh, the horse isn't real?
We're gonna make
no,
them.
But
okay,
the
he
Chad's,
just gets his hoof and eats a Big Mac like that.
Okay,
the Chad spider was... We saw a big-ass spider, and we're like, damn, that's a Chad spider.
And he has, like, super...
Shatner.
Human. And then he can fucking pick up things with his fucking...
He can, like, lift someone up with, like, his little fucking...
Leg.
Because he's a Chad, because he's... Built as fuck.
So it's Chad.
You see that little spider?
No.
The little baby.
Chad
no.
spider.
Oh,
Chad
so
spider.
Oh, that little, the little.
Yeah. It's like he's an animation. Well.
With the big eyes.
Yeah, he's so cute.
Then Mikey. Mikey's just the word that we just made up. Like they were like
yeah.
Mikey.
One day, that's what we do. But we haven't said it in a while.
You guys, what's that meme where it's like Mikey? Make him say yes.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Fuck. I know memes, but I don't know what that means.
Oh, I know what you're talking about, Lizzie.
Yankee
like,
no brim.
He said no.
Well,
make him say
no. Yes.
The Yankee long brim.
Make him say yes. Yeah. I'm pretty sure
what the
she
fuck,
was like
Richard?
Getting what the fuck, Richard?
I like that the guy throws the frisbee.
Richard. What the fuck, Richard?
Wait.
Stop vaping on the pizza.
Oh, alright, have you seen the one where it's like, Adam.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what it is. It's like, stop vaping on the pizza.
Yeah,
and he's
yeah.
like, Adam.
I can't
yeah,
believe.
He
oh
this.
Yeah, he did
I
the
can't believe he
did the tornadoes.
Right? Yeah, that one, and he goes like that.
Or the vroom vroom.
There's this funny ass video. Go. I don't know if you guys have seen this one, but it was in like some kind of like fail compilation. Some dude was sitting at his desk in like his college dorm, but like those typical ones where it's like a two chairs and then the door. This guy went out the door and threw a pair of scissors, and it hit him in the arm like that, and it was in there, and he got up and he's like. Oh my god. He's like, I have to go to the hospital now. And I was like, holy shit.
He just walked in with scissors
so
in his arm.
They were like the big ones.
That's like a
dude,
lot of adrenaline.
Deep in his arm.
I
was like, god damn. It wasn't bleeding though, which was funny. But holy shit, that was so funny.
Oh my god. I'm trying to process this.
Oh, like those videos where they put their hand on the dartboard. And they like go bam.
Yeah, you see where he's like he has his hand on the dartboard and he throws it and it went right into his head.
Yeah,
he's like,
I love that.
He's like, he's like, dude, there's a dart in your head. There's a dart in your head. And he's like,
okay.
He's like, okay.
What?
He's all chill about it.
Yeah,
and it went right into
so
his head.
Funny.
That shit's.
Oh my god, I don't know, boy.
Or like the one where the guy where he got, I don't know what it's from. I saw this video where the guy, where he's like a bodybuilder, right?
Uh-huh.
And he has these big old thick calves, or not, no, thighs.
Mm-hmm.
And they drew a little, like a little dartboard thing right there. And then so they got darts and they would throw it at his leg.
Oh my god.
I think I saw someone have that like on their back and they were just like, yep, yeah. And I was
like a bunch in the back?
Yeah.
Oh,
but there's that one video,
wait,
I think
I'm trying to see if it's the one.
Everyone in their life. Did you get it?
Oh my gosh! Dude, that's actually like in his head. He just turns around and it's the.
It looks like Roger.
That's funny. He's like, dude. He's like, dude, there's a dart in your head. That's just fucking funny.
Como se queda, dude? And he just like.
That's funny. I think, but the funny ones, that the ones on the hands, they always go, oh yeah, ah! Like crazy as fuck. Some of them just like, wow. But some just,
wow.
But yeah, wow. Shit's cool.
That's crazy. I remember one time I stepped on a nail and I didn't have a reaction, and I was just like, my chancla was stuck, so I was like, why can't I get off? And then I just yank it off, and then my foot is bleeding, obviously, and I'm like, huh.
I remember, like, when I was, like, I don't know, I think I was maybe 10 or something, I went fishing to Patagonia.
Oh, my God.
And so I was with my little cousin. I was with my little cousin right there, and we were fishing off a boat. And I think, so, like, I was ahead of him right here, and he was right next to me. And then, like, so he went like that. And, like, all I know, like that, I just got hit right here. And then, like, I was, like, okay, like that. And then I started, like, me being, like, 10 years old, like, I freaked the fuck out. There was a hook underneath my jaw right here.
Oh, my God.
And, like, me being 10 years old, I was all screaming. I was, like, oh, whatever, like that. And I thought, that was, like, you're fine, like that. And he just takes it out Jesus. Like that. But he went like that.
Your cousin's Yankee. He's like, what?
Yeah, he was like,
he's like, I got a big one.
It was funny that he was like, as soon as you got right there, I didn't feel it at first, but then, like, once I noticed, like, it was right there, I freaked the fuck out. I was like, oh. And started crying and everything. So
I have, like, I remember, I think it was here or something. Mm-hmm. I was with him, and I stepped on a nail outside, and it went through my shoe. And I was like, oh, that's new. But
sorry.
I was bleeding like crazy out of my foot. But there was one time, there's two times actually, in elementary school where my body was riddled with thorns. And, like, you'd think that it wouldn't be that hard. Where'd you go?
I don't know where she went. She just left.
Well,
she's trying to.
I think I talked about it one time. There's this place called Care.
It's because someone's outside. I'm going to back. Okay. But you guys keep talking. It's silent right now.
Who is?
Well, no, it's fine.
What?
It's,
Oh, okay.
the place I went to called Care, I think I spoke about it like two episodes ago or some shit, and you would just go there before or after school, and you'd be there. I was on the basketball court up against the gate, right in front of the, like, the basketball hoop. I was leaning against that, but apparently I was like, man, this shit hurts. And then when I got back home, I was like, Mom, my back hurts. She lifted up my shirt, and my back was covered in thorns. I just, like, from top to bottom, thorns. And I was like, what? She had to pull out, like, so many thorns out of my back.
And you,
like,
were just like, it hurts.
It hurt like a bitch. I think I started crying afterwards, but then there was one time, I know I spoke about this one, where there was a bee on the table, and I'm allergic to bees. So, like, it got, like, right in my face. I, like, wah, jumped out. Ran away without looking, and I shoulder bumped all the way into this big ass saguaro cactus.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So brain, can you just, like, sit
right
there?
Yeah.
No.
Andrew.
Okay.
And my arm was just bleeding, and the guy, the janitor guy, was like, "Hey, who's the school of the nurse?" And I was in there. I was like, "The whole arm is bleeding." Like, my blood was lighter than shit, though. It was like going like crazy. I was like, I freaked the fuck out.
I would have freaked out.
Yeah. Wait, I
didn't
to
hear
go.
Anything.
This one, you're too late.
Yeah.
This one time, we have this house in Mexico, and you know the screens that go over the light bulbs? Like, it's just a glass screen over the light bulb. I guess it was loose. But I was really little at the time, so I was showering with my sister, okay? And we just got out. We, like, whipped open the shower curtain, and the screen comes falling down, and it's really thin glass. And we turned around as soon as we saw it fall, but the glass shattered, and keep in mind, we're butt naked. Okay? And we just started crying, and there's, like, these little triangle shards of glass behind our legs. And my mom's like, what happened? And she saw that it fell down. And she, like, rushed us to the bedroom, and we were, like, laying face down on the bed while she was, like, picking them out.
Oh, man.
And it hurt so bad, and I remember it hurt after, too. I was like, what the fuck?
I remember this one time. It happened recently. So I was drinking, right?
And just so casually.
All the time.
A little bit. But so, and, like, so I was just walking around outside, and then so, like, right around in the front of my house, there's, like, this, like, swing thing right there. And so I was on the roof. I don't know why I was on the roof when I was drinking.
This is the other day.
Yeah, this is the other day. This was the other day. So I got down it at that, and, like, I was, you know, I was okay enough, you know, to, like, realize what I was doing. So there's on the swing, whatever, there's, like, this one single bar that goes across the whole thing on the top. And so I was thinking, like, if I could just slide across it, I think it'll be good. I'll make it. I'll make it so that as soon as I started letting go of the roof, as soon as I got to the middle, I fell right off of it and I fell into the bench.
Right there. Right there. You can't see it, but it's funny because right now he did something else before that. He said he was on the roof up there, and he had his shirt off. I don't know why he had his shirt off.
Just
like drunk power or some shit. But he's all like sending me videos and he's like, "I'm gonna jump off." I was like, "Do it." And then he sent me one video of him throwing his phone off while I was recording. But then he actually jumped off, and I have the video. It's like a POV of him jumping off.
His POV is just... Oh. Wait, the arm!
And I was dying laughing. That's where that... Well, it's kind of where that picture came from. But it was like right there. Oh, man. There it is. Yeah. He threw off the phone. But that's where that fucking face came from.
Did your phone not break?
I thought it did. The camera looked all weird afterwards.
Yeah,
it's off
the grass.
Well, because the camera looked like it had some weird on it.
Lush.
This
goes it.
But he jumps off the roof all the time. I thought he was on this roof.
Fuck no. Because this thing fucking fall through it.
This thing's thin as fuck. Uh-huh. So I was like, damn, if he's drunk, he has his whole ass weight on here. He might fall through.
Oh, shit.
Or fall on that windmill that's right there and just impale himself.
How the fuck am I going to fall off of that if it's like right there?
I'm drunk as fuck.
Drunk power. But yeah, that's pretty much my whole story. Right there.
I just pictured him fucking folding on that
because I was like this. So I was like this sideways like this, and then I just fell straight back like that, and like I tried catching myself, but boom, right on the fucking thing. But the thing was, it didn't hurt at all, and I just walked it off.
You said he had to run back in through his window.
Because I was outside and no one knew I was outside, so I just fucking ran back inside right after that.
You know, you were talking about that after school thing, care?
Mm-hmm.
After care? What?
No, it was enough. You weren't here.
Sorry.
Just kidding. He had this like after school program. Do you remember the Huber after school program?
21st century.
Yeah. Dude.
It's kind of like that, but like, you know, they would have to like literally watch you. Like,
I was thinking that like that's how we got close, like at first.
Me and you?
Yeah, 21st century.
I wasn't in it.
Really? You were in it. I remember him in it. Cause I remember
close,
Ed.
I think I started getting close to you. Oh, yeah. Happy late birthday, Eduardo. Watch this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, happy late birthday, Ed. I was, like, trying to, like, send you messages if you remember what I'm talking about. I don't know if you want to talk about it.
So.
No.
I think we got close. I don't know. I don't really know necessarily. Roque, maybe?
Roque and my mom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it was funny because my mom was... you know, helping them out one time. I'm not going to say why, but they're helping them out. And, like, my mom was there, and then she found out that I was at her house one time.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, "You were here one time?" I was like,
"Yeah."
Oh, yeah. I was one like, time? That's MJ's house. Because after we were hanging out with Roque, we went back to her house.
Uh-huh.
And we were just chilling there for whatever. Then we went to go get Burger King.
Probably.
My mom was like, "You were at her house?" I was like, "Yeah, is that a problem?" She's like, "No." She's like, "I'm glad you were at least at her house instead of some rando's house."
Right.
So. And then we started doing the Romeo and Juliet thing, so I think
that
helped
it. Oh, yeah,
that was so cool.
Romeo and Juliet was fun.
Well, correction, Romina and Julio.
Oh, Romina and Julio.
That was really fun. I think that was the main reason that I started talking to you, Henry.
It was a fun experience. I'm glad we got to have it. Mr. Cepeda?
Shout out. Mm-hmm. Thanks, G.
I miss Mr. Cepeda.
Are you recording for help?
I don't know.
Who has a timer on?
My phone.
But anywho, if you guys haven't seen that video, it's on my YouTube channel, Leslie Felix. I'm pretty sure I've plugged myself a couple times already.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Just some.
I mean, you could basically, like, if you just let her talk, you're like, Leslie Felix.
Leslie Felix.
Leslie Felix.
Just catch it. Leslie.
Leslie MFG.
My fucking God.
I always say that. What does it stand for?
Yeah, what does it stand
my
for?
My literal initials.
Your name doesn't start with an M.
Yes, it does.
My fucking God.
it's Leslie Malay Felix Garcia.
Well, I said it doesn't
Garcia.
I got a question. I got a question for you.
Go for it.
Well, we always tell us to. We've asked this to like a couple of the people.
Carlos Adana and Sergio.
Yeah, so pretty much everybody. How do you guys feel about cancel culture?
Cancel culture. You want to take that one?
I mean, it's a little like tiring. Be honest, but like I see why it's happening, mm-hmm. But it is tiring to keep up with. I don't really have a strong opinion about it. I'm like, whatever.
Do you follow in it in any sort of way?
No.
Like,
are
like
you about canceling somebody?
Yeah.
Kind of deal.
I could cancel people.
Well, no, like right now, like, wow.
Oh my gosh. Cancel culture. I don't think I really have an opinion on that. I feel like a lot of people are getting canceled right now. But, like, some people have reasons for canceling someone. And then, like, sometimes I feel like they're not valid. Like, they do
uh-huh.
this one
sometimes
thing.
Sometimes it's really not valid.
It's really stupid. But then, like, other people do, like, crazy stuff. Like, I don't know.
Jake Paul.
Yeah. Like, Jake Paul. And I don't know if you guys heard about, like, a lot. You know, like, all the
yeah.
sex trafficking stuff. And it's just, that's just not good. So.
Sex trafficking?
How's that
like
cancel culture?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
That's been like
okay,
a fucking
yeah,
thing
yeah,
forever.
Yeah, but...
But it's really bad right now in Arizona.
Yeah, it is really bad.
Exactly, that's what I meant.
I'm scared.
But that's not cancel culture. That's like...
But like, no. Like, I mean... Okay, I don't know how to explain this, but... Someone start talking so I can figure this out.
Okay.
You mean, wow,
I got this. Do you think 2020 could get any more better? Or could get better, at least?
What? 2020 could get better. I feel like... This pandemic is really, really bad, and I don't see it going away anytime soon. But it's definitely something that we're getting used to, which is a good sign.
Yeah.
Like,
and a bad sign.
I don't...
The toilet paper's back.
I think by the winter time, if it's not at least gone, you know, slightest,
it's
going to get
worse.
You
think it's going to be gone?
No, if it doesn't get
because
gone,
it'll be
then it's going to get bad.
Too.
Right, right.
And then everybody's going to be like, oh... Fuck, man. I don't know if I got COVID or flu.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I see
exactly.
COVID affecting us for
a long time.
A couple
like
years.
Cold, so.
You think we're
I always
here?
Get sick every single winter.
I don't know. Maybe
no,
so.
Yeah, no, me too.
Like last,
I
guess
sick
year?
In the summertime.
Like in December or January,
weird.
I think I got the flu. And I think the year before that too. And the flu's like bad on me.
Mm.
Like, you know.
The flu's
it
scary.
Was, you know who Eileen is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was her birthday. And I was supposed to go to her birthday, and I was supposed to go to school. But I woke up, and I was laying on my arm like this, and my beard was, like, stubbly.
Mm-hmm.
But it felt like knives were all up in my arm.
Oh,
I was
like,
holy
body
shit.
Ouch.
And I was like, damn. And then, I kind of chiefed through the day. I didn't go to school still. But then when I went to her birthday, and I was at her house, everyone was like, man, it's hot as hell in here. And I'm over there, and I'm like, give me all your jackets. I was, like, covered in everybody's jackets. I was like, I'm the coldest bitch in here. Someone put their hand in
the
tent. And then they're like, it's like 1,000 degrees in there. I was like, it's not enough.
I
need to go to Antarctica. Man, it was so bad. I was like shivering the whole time.
That's crazy.
Dude, once I went to school with strep throat. And you know how it's like really contagious?
Yep.
I didn't know I had strep throat at the time. I've never had it before. It was middle school too. I remember I was feeling really sick, but I was running. I was like running out of my absences because I'm always absent and tardy. And I had a fever that morning, and it was bad, and I was like, I'm still gonna go. And I was there all day, like, out of it. I wasn't paying attention to anything. I was just there for the attendance at that point. And I got home, and I was like, Mom, I'm dying. And she took me to the doctors, and the doctors were like, did you go to school today? You have strep throat. And I was like, what's strep? I never heard that.
What the fuck?
And then she was like, yeah, it's really contagious. Don't let anyone drink out of your drinks. And I was like, oh.
You're like, oops.
Wrong bitch.
Not me.
There was this one time, because me and Marco went to summer school because I had, like, missed a bunch, so I failed math. And I was there with him. And one of these mornings, you know, summer school is like, oh, you can't miss.
Mm-hmm.
Or, like, you can miss probably, like, once.
One.
And I think I'd already missed one time because, like, I get sick, so
mm-hmm.
I went, but in the morning I had taken medicine, and I took, like, this medicine that makes you real sleepy, and, you know, I was kind of chilling for a bit, and then out of nowhere, I was like, damn, I'm tired as fuck. Like, I was like, I'm really tired as fuck, and then he's like, yeah, and I was like, I don't know, I slept normal last night, and then I was like, after, like, a couple minutes, I was like, damn, I'm real tired now. And then my mom called me, or I think maybe... Yeah, she either called me or called the office, and she's like, hey, my son just took the wrong medication, like a shit ton of wrong medication. And I was like,
oh
that's
yeah,
why.
I remember
and then
that.
When we went in there, they're like, are you fine? I was like, yeah. They're like, what's wrong with you? Like, I'm just tired. Yeah, I was zen as shit. I was like, but I was tired as fuck. And my mom's like, you took that medicine that's supposed to make people fall asleep, like, hella hard. And I was like, that explains why I'm so tired. I wasn't even mad. I was just like,
to go home and get
I was like,
to sleep.
I was like, that explains. I didn't even go to sleep.
You
I was
didn't.
Like, no. Ah, oh, man, dude,
you
that shit hurts.
Crazy.
Yeah, but I was like, damn. that was pretty funny. And, you know, my mom was like, why didn't you look? I was like, I didn't have my glasses on. And I was just kind of like, I need to get to this place quick as fuck. I was like... So, yeah, that's just what happened.
This is fucking funny.
That is really funny.
Ever since then, I've had to, like really look. I mean, I have accidentally taken medication before. Cause, like,
accidentally.
Ibuprofen, like, you know how ibuprofen looks? It's just, like, white like that. But my mom had another bottle right next to it, and it was just... slightly thinner, and I was like, there we go. And then I took it, and then I was like, well, that wasn't ibuprofen. So I went back and I took the ibuprofen, and my mom's like, oh my god, why did you do that? And I was like, I'm fucking fine.
I'll make it through.
Medicine hardly even works on me to begin with. So okay, like,
are you like immune?
Oh, to ibuprofen. For like the past like 4 years, I've taken like at least once a day. For like the past 4 years, ever since I started high school.
Damn.
Ibuprofen hardly works.
He's all drugged out every day.
No, I'm not. I have a headache every whole last day.
You need to get on a good one.
Yeah, I need to stop taking ibuprofen for like 6 weeks, and then I can do it, and it'll hit hard. But
they'll take it for like a whole year, and you take it.
Shit. I'm like those people that say that they get high off ibuprofen.
The fuck?
I've
never heard
of
that.
If you know who you are,
you smoke,
you're a bitch. Because I know someone that's all like, there's dude, they're like, I'm high as fuck right now. I'm like, why would you take ibuprofen? I was like, get the fuck out of my face.
There's just like a glove for ibuprofen.
Like painkillers?
What?
Perk 30.
I'll send you this TikTok.
Perk 30s. You should invest in one
or like painkillers. Like, they're like, oh man, painkillers get me fucked up. And I was like, painkillers make me talk. When I'm on a painkiller.
You take oxys?
No. But when I'm on a painkiller, I'm like, I'm just talking the whole time.
That's just fucking fun. Tic Tacs.
Did you do?
No.
Oh, I thought you just eat them like Tic Tacs.
Eat them?
Yeah, I break them up and put them in a Tic Tac container.
I'm supposed to eat them. They're like these little like painkillers that they give little kids. They're like really small painkillers.
Like
no, and they come in a green box, like a white and green box.
Fuck. I have no idea
what you're talking about. That sounds like an allergy medicine, honestly.
Ah, never
mind. Like the gummies?
Flintstones gummies.
They're gummies. Whatever. I ate a bunch of them because they tasted really good.
I think I might know what you're talking about.
Like, they're not supposed to taste good, but like, since they're for kids, they're not that bad. I ate a bunch of them and I woke up my mom. Not because I was like scared. I didn't know that like you can like die or anything. I was really little. And I was like, I was just trying to confess to her that I ate a bunch of pills. I was like, I'm sorry, Ma. I ate all the pills, and I was like, I'm in. She was like, and she took me to the bathroom, and she started, like, shoving her finger down my throat, and I was like,
that shit doesn't work for me. I can't throw up that way.
I didn't die.
If I've ever had to throw up that way, I can't. I
have a shitty gag reflex.
Yeah.
I'll be brushing my teeth right there, shit. And then just fucking start gagging.
You just throw up while you're brushing your teeth.
I'm like, fuck, I gotta brush my teeth again.
Wait.
What?
What did you say?
Well, you said, oh, brush I throw teeth up. Again. You said I throw up and then I gotta brush my teeth again.
Oh, I thought you said I'm not gonna brush my teeth ever again.
No, I brush my teeth every goddamn day. You know, do you guys know what like Ludens are?
Huh?
Like the throat lozenges?
What?
Like Ludens?
No.
They're called Ludens?
Loose.
Ludens.
No.
So that's what the brand's
Ricola,
called.
Ricola, or whatever
so
the fuck it's called.
Instead of like cough medicine, you know how cough drops, they taste like shit.
I can eat a whole fucking bag of cough drops.
Sometimes cough drops.
Shit, that hit different.
Well, these Ludens, they're like cherry, and it's like, you remember your little cousin's little party?
Yeah.
And he had the candy, like the little cherry
candies. Yeah, the red ones.
It tastes just like those, and I would eat them so much to the point, you know, they're supposed to help your throat. Mm-hmm. I would eat so much that it would make my throat hurt. And I was like, damn, I guess I gotta eat more. Bro, it became so bad.
Positive.
It became so bad, I'd be like, every time we go to like a CVS, I'm like, give me those bitches.
Like a whole addict. Give me those bitches.
I like secrets.
Yeah.
Give me
those.
I need
secrets. Secrets.
Huh? Ryan Seacrest?
No, Secret.
Ryan
Seacrest. They're fucking
Big Time Rush.
Cough drops.
I
don't even
know what we're talking about.
I lost the conversation.
What about Scooby-Doo gummies and shit, bitch?
Oh, those Scooby-Doo gummies, shit.
What about Scooby-Doo snacks? You guys ever had when you were little? Don't they just taste like they used to be good as fuck when they first came out.
They used to give them to us at care.
And they just taste like graham crackers.
I know, but it's a Scooby snack.
I just said that. I know. Like, nobody listened to me.
That's why I had to say it louder.
They got that extra shit in there.
They've been ignoring me this whole podcast.
What are you talking about?
I've said they ain't talking about.
You bet.
MJ
you
had a carrier side.
Interrupter. Kind of. I've noticed.
Your mom is calling you, by the way.
I will. Yeah.
So, how much time do we have left?
Bueno.
Probably a
group clip. My mom is gonna kill me.
Probably do a little bit of an intro or real quick.
Yeah, I gotta go. Go ahead.
Ready for this? Okay. Yeah. Anyways, okay. Thank you guys for watching, listening, whatever you guys are doing. And so we would like to thank our guests Leslie and MJ being on here.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Their Instagrams and
their socials.
And stuff are gonna be in there, and start watching their videos too. Well,
if you guys start watching
TikToks.
No, not my TikTok.
Why not?
All my YouTube videos.
Right.
At Leslie Felix.
Yeah.
You guys want to come back on the Halloween one or the Christmas one? We could. Just let us know. We can do more stuff really that we fun. Just did today.
Mm-hmm. It was fun.
Yeah. It was good.
Time passed fast.
Well, thank you guys for watching. Have a good night.
Okay.
Good night. Bye-bye.